President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has created two new special economic zones in Pasig City and Cavite. In his proclamations, Marcos designated several parcels of land with an aggregate of over 124,000 square meters in Ugong, Pasig City to create an information technology park, which will be known as Arcovia City. Of course, this, for those who are familiar, this is within the Mega World Township Project, Arcovia City. Now, aside from this, parcels of land in Tanza, Cavite will also become part of the Metrocas Industrial Estate Special Economic Zone with an area of around 400,000 square meters. Marcos issued the two proclamations under the Special Economic Zone Act of 1995 and upon the recommendation of the Board of Directors of the Philippine Economic Zone Authority. Under the administration's five-year Philippine Development Plan, ecozones will play a vital role due to its ability to accelerate economic growth and attract investments. The Philippine National Railway is seeking more funds from the national government. It says the additional money will be used to provide bus fare subsidies to passengers affected by the five-year suspension of its train services, which was done to make way for the construction of the North-South Commuter Railway. The suspension displaced some 20,000 daily commuters, forcing them to take buses instead. But passengers have been complaining taking a bus is more expensive and causes delays in their travel. Philippine Environment Department urging the public to conserve water as four dams are now under close monitoring due to falling water levels. While the government gives assurance there is still sufficient water supply, State Weather Bureau Pagasa has warned the declining trend for Angat Dam may last until the end of the month and possibly even extend until May. While three other dams, the San Roque, Magat, and Pantabagan dams, are all below the so-called rule curve, or the required water level to be able to comfortably carry out its services. The DNR is calling on the management of villages and condominiums in Metro Manila to help manage water use and check on water meters for potential leaks. Now here's a quick look at the flash business headlines from overseas. Levi Strauss raising its annual profit forecast, citing the apparel maker's recent cost savings from job cuts and less aggressive discounts on its jeans and denim clothing. Well, that news sent shares up 7% in extended trade. Levi's has already reduced its global corporate workforce, consolidated its operations in Europe, and exited lower margin businesses such as its Denizen brand and European footwear enterprise. The apparel retailer recorded a restructuring charge of $116 million in the first quarter, while reporting a loss of $10.6 million compared to a profit of $114.7 million a year earlier. Now moving on, Samsung Electronics is expected to post a near nine-fold increase in its first quarter profit year-on-year as rebounding semiconductor prices lift earnings from a low base caused by a severe chip downturn. Operating profit for the world's biggest maker of memory chips and TVs likely rose to 5.7 trillion won or around $4.2 billion in the quarter ended March 31, according to estimates. If this is indeed the case, it would be Samsung's highest profit since the third quarter of 2022. Now on to more news. Paramount, which owns classics such as The Godfather, Breakfast at Tiffany's, as well as blockbuster franchises like Mission Impossible, Star Trek, and Transformers, well, that group is in talks to enter exclusive merger discussions with Skydance days after it received a $26 billion all-cash offer from private equity firm Apollo Global Management. The deal, if it goes through, will add to consolidation in the media industry that's been grappling with a changing landscape of streaming gaining dominance and the impact from Hollywood strikes from last year, with a soft advertising market adding to the pressure. Meanwhile, Meta's WhatsApp back up on Wednesday after an hours-long outage at the smartphone messaging app disrupted services for thousands of people globally, particularly those in India, the UK, and Brazil. While it didn't specify what technical issues were encountered, it did post on X or Twitter that the issue has been resolved. At its peak, the outage impacted more than 24,000 WhatsApp users in the US, while Instagram users also reported over 5,000 outages, according to data from Down Detector. And finally, South Korea will hold elections on April 10 for its parliament that will determine if President Yoon Suk-yeol can wrest control of the legislature and advance pro-business policies in the last 3 years of his term, or instead become a virtual lame duck. All 300 seats are up for grabs in the unicameral parliament known as the National Assembly, and Yoon's Conservative People Power Party is trying to flip more than 30 seats to gain the majority now held by the progressive camp led by the main opposition, Democratic Party. Key issues for voters include inflation, a walkout by doctors over benefits issues, and North Korea's provocations.